सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां वसुदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्गणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुकन्मित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दुर्गत्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहं नमत्वोऽन्यत्ति मे निश्चिता मतिः। I'm sorry. So we looked at the objection by Purva Pakshi that Bandha cannot be Mithya. And if it is not Mithya, if Bandha is Satya, and before using the word Bandha, he explained what are these Bandhas. So Bandha he explained as earlier he said, Ahankaradi Dehanta Anatma Bhuta Drishya Vastu Jatam. The entire group of things that you call as Anatma, he called with the word Bandha. It cannot be Mithya, it cannot be unreal, it has to be real. And if it is Satya, after establishing that, तस्मात् बंध सत्य ही सेज सत्यत्वाद एव ज्ञानेन बंध निवृत्याशा निरर्थका एव देर बाय व्हाट इज सत्य कैन नॉट गो बाय सत्य बंध कैन नॉट गो बाय ज्ञान यू विल नीड कर्म उपासना इत्यादि दैट इज वेयर ही इज कमिंग फ्रॉम बट ही लैंड ऑन इट एंड ही सेड दैट वी नीड सामग्री फॉर anything to happen. If you are saying that something is a result of something else, then you have to talk about that something else. What comes about and comes together and creates a product. If you say vikara is adhyasa, adhyasa is a result of avidya and therefore it is unreal. This is the Siddhanti's argument. How can it be an adhyasa? Purvapakshi says, I have already established that it cannot be adhyasa. So, bandha is satya. Now, if you still argue, says the Purvapakshi to the Siddhanti, if you still were to argue that it is an adhyasa, bandha is an adhyasa, the deha is an adhyasa, the anatma prapancha is an adhyasa, then you have to talk about samagris. And Purvapakshi says, I'll help you out. I know what you are going to talk about, so I'll help you out. He says, let me talk about samagris, things that come together to make up adhyasa. What do you need? So he said, adhyasa samagriha. So that there is a tippana. What is samagri? Samagri nama karana kalapaha. Group of karanas, group of causes that come together. Samagri is a word used in, in vernacular languages, all of the, many of the Indian languages to talk about, when you're cooking something, what is the samagri? You put something together and in a right order with the right quantity you put together, you get a very tasty dish. Similarly, this so-called tasty dish for the jiva is this prapancha. Because it is bhogya prapancha, jiva wants to have bhoga. It has to have come together due to something. And specifically adhyasa, then you have to talk about adhyasa samagri. That is karana kalapa, group of karanas. Yatha pakasya chulyuk udaka kashtadi. And Tippanakara gives this example of pakasya. When you are cooking something, for that what are the ingredients needed? So samagri really means ingredient. Chulli, udaka, kashtadi. So whatever you are cooking, those are needed. But other than those cooking ingredients, you also need chulli. You need a stove. You need a stove. You need, in the oldest thing, the not a gas stove, but you need the wooden stove. You know, where you coal, or you know, you made up of mud or something. So chulli, then udaka, you will need water definitely to boil water and then cook. And kashtadi, to light a fire, you'll need wood, wooden pieces. So that is the samagri for paka. Adhyasa, what is the samagri? He says adhyasa samagris are 5. Satya vastu anubhava janya samskaraha. There is samskara needed, which has to be janita, janya. It should be brought about by impression created by anubhava of a satya vastu. There has to be, let's say, if you say rajju sarpa, you saw sarpa. Sarpa is an adhyasa. The Purvapakshi says, I agree. Now, this sarpa is an adhyasa to happen on rajju. The person who has this erroneous cognition, he should have sarpa samskara in his mind. That will happen only if he has had sarpa anubhava. That sarpa has to be satya, it cannot be mithya. So he has had a satya sarpa anubhava, which becomes one of the samagris to create this mithya sarpa when he sees rajju in dim light. So that is first samagri. Second is pramatru doshaha. Pramatru dosha. Pramatru should have dosha. Some defect should be there in the pramatru. The knower. So Tippanakara says, who is pramata? Jeevaha. Now let's take an aside. See, there are these questions, you know, or who is a pramata? First, we have to know that there is a triad that generally is talked about. Jnana, Jnaya, and the Jnata. Jnata is pramata. So, Shrota, Manta, Jnata, Karta, Bhokta, all these are with Trich, Trijanta Pratya. They make the agent out of the, or the subject for the particular dhatu which it is used. Trich Pratya. So, declines like Karta, Kartaro, Kartara, Pramata, Pramataro, Pramataraha. So, this Pramata, knower Jiva, Jnata, Pramata. This Pramata is towards whom the entire Shastra is focused. It is not focused towards the Sakshi. Sakshi is Shuddha Chaitanya, also called as Kutastaha. Kutastha, Brahma, these are the words. At the Samashti Brahma, at the Kutastha Atma, Jivatma, Sakshi, Kevala Atma. There are many such words used. Pramatru Chaitanyam. Pramatru Chaitanyam is for the Jivas. For Sakshi, you use, you know, Kutastha, Brahma, Ityadi. But for Pramata Jiva, there is nothing other than Chaitanya. Shruti says that there is nothing other than Chaitanya. But we have to be careful when you use the words. Words Nama Rupatmaka Prapancha. The entire prapancha is Nama Rupatmaka. So when you use that, there we can't be, there we can't discount that everything is Chaitanya. There we have to use the right words. So when you are talking about Pramata, you should not be talking about Kutastha Chaitanya Sakshi. Sakshi and Pramata cannot be mixed up as the same word. They are not. So who is this Pramata now? How this Sakshi Chaitanya becomes Pramata by association with something, right? So what is its... Sakshi has an Upadhi. When you say Sakshi, Shuddha Chaitanya talked about a Sakshi, there has to be a Sakshya. That Sakshya, Sakshi is still individual, at Samashti level called as Brahma. So to individualize a Sakshi, where this discussion took place a couple of days back, who is the Sakshi, has to be Nana. We don't have an issue there. Sakshi Aneka, we have no problem. But Sakshi, who has Upadhi of Antakkarana, not of the Vritti, not of the Vishaya, ही हैज उपाधि ऑफ अंतकरण. वी के नॉट से वृत्ति इज एन वृत्ति इज ऑल्सो अंतकरण कार्य, लेट्स कॉल इट. यू के नॉट डू दैट. यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल ऑफ यूजिंग दी वर्ड्स. सो इन द ट्रायड यू हैव प्रमाता, प्रमातृ एज अ प्रातिपदिक, प्रमाता एज अ डिक्लाइंड वर्ड इन पुल्लिंग. दिस प्रमाता इज फॉर हूम द एंटायर शास्त्र इज, वेदर कर्मकांड और मोक्ष शास्त्र ज्ञान कांड. दिस प्रमाता जीवा, संसारी जीवा, ही इज संसारी. वाई इज ही संसारी? बिकॉज ही हैज नॉट अंडरस्टूड जीव ब्रह्म नापरा. ही हैज अज्ञान. सो दिस जीवा इज अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस. वी सॉ द अदर डे, वी सॉ डेफिनेशंस प्रॉपर गिवन बाय साधु दैट जीवा और प्रमाता इज प्रतिबिंब चैतन्य, अनदर वर्ड. और लाइक घटाकाशा ही इज अवच्छिन्न. सो अवच्छिन्न चैतन्य, विशिष्ट चैतन्य. बट विशिष्ट विषय, व्हाट इज द विशेषण? विशेषण इज अंतकरण. व्हाट इज द लिमिटिंग फैक्टर? व्हाट इज दी कंडीशनिंग फैक्टर? अंतकरण, नॉट वृत्ति. वृत्ति कम्स एंड गोज बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट 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 इज द विषय. इट्स अ विषयाकार वृत्ति. विषयाकार वृत्ति इज नॉट देयर इन द अंतकरण ऑल द टाइम. समथिंग एल्स इज गोइंग ऑन. बट व्हेन वन इज अप्रमाता, देयर हैज टू बी अ प्रमेय वस्तु. When the प्रमेय वस्तु इज देर, देर इज दैट प्रमेय आकार. प्रमेय इज कर्म, कर्म टू दी व्याकरण, कर्म टू दी सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट डिविजन. वी से सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट डिविजन. सो इन द क्रिया देर हैज टू बी अ कर्ता एंड कर्म. द कर्ता हैपन्स टू बी प्रमाता जीव. कर्म हैपन्स टू बी दी ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज सीन, घटपटादि विषया. Then the घटाकार वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस. दैट वृत्ति इज द मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ द अंतकरण. द चैतन्य विच इज देर इन द प्रमाता, अंडरलाइन द प्रमाता. प्रमाता इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द चैतन्य, ऑल राइट. बट वी के नॉट से दैट दैट द रीजन एवरीथिंग इज वन. एवरीथिंग इज नॉट वन. वेन यू हैव नाम रूप दे आर सेगमेंटेड, अदरवाइज वील नॉट हैव संसार. सो द व्यवस्था इज सच दैट प्रमाता इज द अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य, नॉट वृत्ति विशिष्ट. अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य इज प्रमाता. साक्षी हैज नो बिजनेस देयर बिकॉज साक्षी इज अ डिफरेंट नेम. ही हैज एन उपाधि ऑफ ऑफ अंतकरण. बोथ हैव अंतकरण. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस? वन इज इन साक्षी इट इज एन उपाधि, इन जीव इट इज अ विशेषण. देयर इज रियल सेगमेंटेशन. दे आर नॉट सेपरेट. यू कैनॉट सेपरेट आउट जीवा एंड कॉल हिम जीवा फ्रॉम दी अंतकरण. देर जीवा वोंट सर्वाइव एज जीवा. जीवा विल बिकम साक्षी इफ यू सेपरेट आउट एंड देन ही विल बिकम ब्रह्म कॉग्निटिवली. देर इज नो बिकमिंग. इट इज ऑल कॉग्निटिव. देन दिस अंतकरण विच टेक्स दी फॉर्म ऑफ दी विच गोज आउट. अंतकरण गोज आउट थ्रू द रिस्पेक्टिव इंद्रिया. वेन यू सी अ घटा घटा देन इट गोज थ्रू आउट थ्रू चक्षुर इंद्रिया. Then it forms a vritti vyapti, meaning it changes the shape. Antakarana modifies its shape to fit the vishaya, ghatakara. If it is shabda that I hear some sound, then for that hearing to take place, the antakarana makes the shabdakara vritti through the karana golaka. Karana golaka is involved. Earlier chakshu golaka, chakshur indriya is involved. Chakshu golaka. अंतर्गत चक्षुर इंद्रिय इज इन्वॉल्व. दिस इज नॉट टॉक्ड अबाउट इन वेदांता बिकॉज वी डोंट केयर एज टू विच गोलका एंड विच इंद्रिया बिकॉज वृत्ति इज सेम. वी जस्ट केयर अबाउट वृत्ति. नैयायिकास डोंट केयर अबाउट वृत्ति विदाउट दी चक्षु और दी श्रोत्र इंद्रिय और एनी इंद्रिया. सो दे हैव अ व्यवस्था वेर दे टॉक अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी इंद्रिया इन्वॉल्व इन ईच एंड एवरी कॉग्निशन. सो दे डिस्कस इन दैट. There is a lot of Gaurava in that methodology. We take the shortcut method. We should not have unnecessary complications. The simplest of the methods, in multiple methods, simplest has to be used. Occam's razor, you know, it's called Occam's razor. So Laghavam is there in Vedanta where we say we don't care which Indriya is involved, which Golaka is involved. That is not to say that they are not involved. They are definitely involved. गोलक अंतर्गत इंद्रिय इज डेफिनेटली इन्वॉल्व इन ईच एंड एवरी कॉग्निशन ऑफ विषय विच इज आउटसाइड. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज विषय गत प्रत्यक्ष. सो प्रत्यक्ष इज अ प्रमाण एंड प्रत्यक्ष वॉट प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान यूज इज प्रत्यक्ष प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान ऑफ द विषय विच इज बहि आउटसाइड. फॉर दैट यू नीड इंद्रियाज. देन देर इज ज्ञानगत प्रत्यक्ष वेर यू यू डोंट हैव अ विषय आउटसाइड इट इज इन साइड. सो इट इज कॉल्ड ज्ञानगत प्रत्यक्ष. ज्ञान कैन टेक प्लेस इन स्वप्न ऑल्सो. यू कैन वाई टेक कैन टेक प्लेस डेफिनेटली डज दैट्स वाई वी हैव स्वप्न. इन स्वप्न वी सी द एंटायर प्रपंच. प्रपंच ज्ञान इज देर अ डिफरेंट प्रपंच ऑल राइट बट स्टिल देर इज ज्ञान ऑफ घटपटादि विषय ऑफ स्वप्न अंतर्गत. स्वप्न अंतर्गत घटपटादि विषय आर देर. There is jnana relating to that. That is within. Even in waking, sukha dukkha adi, what is the vishaya? There is no vishaya. Sukha dukkha are within. There also vrittis are needed. So vrittis are needed in both cases, whether or not there is an object outside. Whether or not there is an object. Thereby the pratyaksha also jnana is divided into vishaya antaragata and jnana antaragata. Let that be aside. Now in this triad, Prameya is there, Pramata is there, and Pramiti is there. Pramiti is that jnana which takes place. Pramana has to be there for Prameya to be known by Pramata, giving rise to Pramiti or Prama. Pramana is Pramakaranam. It is a means to Prama. Prama is valid knowledge which cannot be negated and prior unknown. Abadita, it should be Abadita, it should not go away in time, otherwise it is Brahma. It should not be negated by, countered by any other Pramana. And it should be Anadigata. Anadigata means it is unknown. It is unknown. That is how you differentiate Smriti. Smriti is something which is not known per se. I mean, Smriti is something which is already known. But here, it is Anadigata, Abadita. And that kind of a Vishayaka Jnana is called as Prama. And Karana, the means which is used for that, is called as Pramana. In the Bahya Vishaya, these Pramanas are not Vritti. Pramana is Chakshur Indriya, Shrotra Indriya, all these Indriyas are Pramana. And then they give rise to Prama. These Pramanas give rise to Prama, Pratyaksha Prama. So we differentiate the Prama also based on whether it is Pratyaksha or something else. Others are there, other Pramanas. So Pramana is differentiated and the Prama also is differentiated. Now this Pratyaksha, when it is taking place, this Jiva towards whom the entire Shastra is focused, he is associated, he in the sense he is formed with association of Chaitanya with Antakkarana. So Antakkarana itself is tainted with all the karmas. Thereby he'll have Sukha Dukkha also in the same Antakkarana. That Sukha Dukkha is Pratyaksha without Indriya being in play. And thereby it is called as Sakshi Pratyaksha. Sakshi Pratyaksha does not mean vrittis aren't there. Vrittis do take place. However, there is sukhakara vritti, dukkhakara vritti within. That is the difference. Sakshi is cognizing within. Pramata is cognizing something outside. What is happening is that we saw that the vritti goes outside through any of these indriyas. The indriyas go out through the golakas, taking along the antakkarana there, and then it makes a vritti. It makes an akara, shabdakara, sparshakara, whatever it is, you know, based on whatever is the object, that kind of akara. Akara is not a form. Form can happen only with something which has shape. Sound does not cannot be called to have a shape. Touch cannot be called to have a shape, but still we say akara. That's why akara is a better word. It is not form. It is in the form. In the form is different from form. It does not have to take the form, which is a physical form. It can be a sound form, in the form of a sound, in the form of a touch. So this is the phrase that we have to use because of the limitations of the language. That's why if you stick to Sanskrit, we'll say Shabdakaravurti, Sparshakaravurti. Ghatakara vritti is at Rupakara vritti. All these are possible. And when the vritti forms, we call it as vritti vyapti. This chaitanya, which is arudha, on that vritti, vrittyarudha chaitanya or vritti antargata chaitanya, either way you call it, the chaitanya is ever there, but chaitanya by itself cannot do anything. Then vritti do something? Vritti is jada, it cannot do anything. So vritti has to be associated with chaitanya. Now that association is also figurative. Chaitanya is always there. Just like in Shruti, Shruti says that having created this Purusha, this Ishvara entered the Sharira as Jiva. There is no separate entering. During the creation, there is entry. But that entry is there in the Pancha Mahabhutas also. Does it matter? Yes, it does matter. When it has already entered, why this re-entry talked about? That re-entry is figurative. Why is it figurative? Because we have to show that this Jiva is Chaitanya. Jiva is Chaitanya. There is Chaitanya. He is sentient. I mean to say he is sentient. Unlike all these Mahabhutas, Mahabhuta Karyas, Sharira, but that Sharira, which has become Sharira of a Jiva, their sentience has to be shown. To show that the Shruti talks about entry, that there is no real entry, but it is shown as a Pratibimba. That Pratibimba takes place in the Antakarana, which has Sattva that can reflect. It is a Sattva Karya. Sattva, Aumsha of Mahabhutas, therefore it can reflect, whereas the insentient things cannot reflect, they do not have antakkarana. Thereby, it is talked about in such a manner. Now, these vrittis themselves form in the Prakruta topic. Vrittis are formed when Ghatakara vritti takes place, Sukhakara vritti takes place. That time, Chaitanya is talked about is as being, you know, as Arudha on vritti. Something is not happening, something special is not happening there. Chaitanya is already there, but there is something special. That vritti comes to life. It wasn't having life, so to say. It wasn't able to do any karya. Antakarana is jada, although Chaitanya is there, some sambandha, tadatmya sambandha has to be there. Pratibimba has to take place for jiva to come up and antakarana to become antakarana, for it to become karana, just by having a mind, it does not become functional. For it to become functional, it has to have that sentience which lends itself. That lending itself to act out is called as Arudha, that Arudha Kriya. That it becomes Arudha. It is figurative. Oh, everything is figurative. In Vedanta, everything is figurative. The entire Paribhasha is figurative. The Bandha is also Mithya. Moksha is also Mithya. So in this, if you start analyzing and hair split as to what was it not Arudha earlier, is it Arudha now? It is figurative. We have to understand that. We know this. It is Arudha means Chaitanya was already there. But Arudha means what? It is not really piggybacking vritti. Therefore, both words are used. They're used by some pandits to explain. Tikakaras use that Arudha. Or, you know, avachinna. These are words used to show that there is some kind of sambandha. Nayayikas will talk about in a different manner. Sanyoga sambandhava, samavayava, samsarga. All these words are used by Nayayikas. We prefer to use some other words. Here especially, sadhu prefers to use different words because not everyone has that kind of a core tarka background. But some is assumed. You need to have some background and be very careful when you use words. Should not be used everything interchangeably. Just because everything is Chaitanya. So that vritti arudha chaitanya, which was already there in antakarana, which modified in vritti also there, because Chaitanya pervades through the antakarana into the vritti, just like it pervaded into akasha, the first created Mahabhuta, and फ्रॉम आकाश टू वायु, वायु टू अग्नि, अग्नि टू जला, जला टू पृथ्वी, पृथ्वी टू ऑल दीज कार्यास ऑफ सूक्ष्म इन टू दी शरीर ऑल्सो एंड दी प्रपंच ऑल्सो, बट दी प्रपंच रिमेन्स जड़ा इंक्लूडिंग दी शरीर, बट दी अंतकरण ऑल्दो जड़ा टेक्स दिस संबंध ऑफ चैतन्य एंड ब्रिंग्स इट टू दी स्थूल शरीर ऑल्सो एंड मेक्स इट एक्टिव. दैट जीव प्राणधारणे, दिस जीव हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्राणधारण. दैट प्राणधारण इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, इट कैन रिटेन लाइफ जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस चैतन्य रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन द अंतकरण एंड गिविंग इट जीवत्व. नाउ दिस वृत्ति विच इज फैसिलिटेटिंग दिस नॉलेज दैट विल टेक प्लेस आफ्टर वृत्ति व्याप्ति. द वृत्ति बाय इटसेल्फ कुडंट हैव टेकन अवे अज्ञान ऑफ दैट घटा. In the example of ghata, ghatakara vritti, when it takes place, it cannot, vritti by itself cannot take it. In fact, vritti cannot even form. The vritti is also forming in the presence of the chaitanya, which is there in some kind of an association. What kind of association, how it takes place, when it takes place, why it takes place, all this you can interpret any which way, but it does take place. It is a prakriya, whether it is real, whether it is figurative, how, why should these words be used, we do not know. But we have to understand the end result so that we can move forward to moksha. Thereby, this vrityaruna chaitanya, which is now capable, chaitanya couldn't have taken away ajnana. Chaitanya is not opposed to anything. That is why bandha is possible. Avidya is there and it continues to be there because jnana is not, I mean, the chaitanya in the shuddha jnana, satyam jnanam, anantam jnana, chaitanya, chit, is not opposed to anything because there is nothing other than it. It is everything is mithya. There cannot be satya and mithya virodha. So where is the virodha? Ajnana you talk about as the nanj being in virodhartha. Where is the virodha? It is not with chaitanya. It is with the jnana. Ajnana and jnana are virodhi to each other. That jnana, there is not satyam jnanam anantam jnanam. That is not chit. That jnana is this vritti rupa jnana, which takes place regarding anything, whether it is regarding ghatapatadi vastu or brahma, atma. So vishaya does not matter, but that jnana is vritti rupa. That vritti rupa jnana which takes place in presence of chaitanya, that opposes ajnana, not chaitanya, shuddha chaitanya. So jnana rupa chit, when has a vritti association, which that jnana rupa vritti association, so jnana rupa chit with in association with this aruda on or avachinna by this vritti rupa jnana, then it can take away ajnana regarding that particular vishaya, where there is ajnana and the jnana should be also regarding the same vishaya. The sarpa jnana cannot take away rajju ajnana. Thereby, there is a specific system, prakriya, and we have to use the right paribhasha to understand what exactly is happening. Then this vritti will take away ajnana. So ghata vritti will take away, that vritti vyapti will take away ghata ajnana. Now the chaitanya underlying is one. Chaitana underlying the pramata, pramey and pramana is all one. So vritti here, this vritti. Now this vritti, which is where the indriyas are used. Now this vritti takes away ajnana and the vritti antargata chaitanya. Vrityavachinna chaitanya or vrityaruda chaitanya as though becomes one. Why as though? Because ajnana was veiling this difference, veiling and bringing out difference between the two. They as though become one. Ajnana going, it is already one. But ajnana has brought about that difference between the two underlying chaitanyas also. That's why we see subject-object division, object-object divisions, the creator and subject division, creator and object division, all these divisions are due to ajnana. This ajnana going away, chaitanya underlying is one. However, the vritti is still jada. जड़ा इन द सेंस द वृत्ति द घटाकार वृत्ति हैज टू बी लिट अप दिस आरूढ़त्वम इज देयर बट दैट आरूढ़त्वम इज देयर टू टेक अवे अज्ञान नाउ दिस चैतन्य विच इज देयर इन द वृत्ति दैट लाइट्स अप द it lights up the ghata. So underlying chaitanya vishaya, ghata vishaya and the vritti chaitanya become one and then it lights up the ghata, ghata vritti. That vritti then it is called as, that is called as phala vyapti. The chaitanya lighting up the vritti is called as phala vyapti. This lighting up is not needed when the vishaya is brahma atma, because atma itself is of the nature of Chaitanya and Swaprakasha. Therefore, no separate light is needed. Ghata does not have its own shine. So, Vritti also does not have its own shine. It is the Vritti Antargata Chaitanya has light, so to say, which lights up. In the mere presence, there is no Kartrutva there. Then, Ayam Ghataha. Further, what? When the Pramatra Chaitanya, which is antakkarana avachinna in the case of Sakshi, but in the case of Jiva, it is, antakkarana avachinna meaning antakkarana vishishta, which is in the case of Jiva, because Jiva cannot be separated from antakkarana. That's why vrittis are possible even. Then these vrittis, which are the modification of the same antakkarana, but the antakkarana still exists within. And this antakkarana, where this chaitanya, which has as though flowed out through the vrittis due to the indriyas going out, dragging the antakkarana and the chaitanya, is already one. So this inner chaitanya of the pramata has as though gone out through the vrittis via the due to the chakshurindriya going out to the ghata via the chakshura golaka, creating the vritti vyapti, taking away the ghata jnana, meaning making the ghatakara vritti, taking away the ghata jnana, that is happens to be tula jnana, and thereby the chaitanya becoming one and lighting up the ghatakara vritti as ayam ghataha. Now when this pramatra chaitanya also becomes one with it, then I say ghatamaham janami. This is the vyavastha. And Sakshi is needed as a separate entity to talk about Sakshi Pratyaksha Vishaya, which happens to be Sukha Dukhadi, which are not outside, they are within. And there also Vritti is involved, which we saw yesterday, the Vritti is involved. However, that Vritti needing does not mean there is Indriya in play. So there is a difference between Indriya being in play or not being in play. And where the Indriya is not in play, we call as Kevala Sakshi Vedya. That Jnana is Kevala Sakshi Vedya. Sukha Dukhadi are known through Vrittis, but by Sakshi being visible to Sakshi, visible or known to Sakshi. So what is Pramanam? Indriyadi Karanam. Indriyadi Karana are Pramana. Indriyadi Karana are Pramaya. All the Indriyas. Adipadena, others also will come in. Prameya is Vishaya, Ghatapatadi. Sukha also. Prameya can be Sukhadi Vishaya also, which are within, and Vishayas outside also, like Ghatapatadi. So with this background, please hold on to this understanding, revisit it, make notes if you need. Do not use words interchangeably, otherwise I won't understand what is in your mind. So let's use a common word. The Paribhasha is meant for that reason only. Use common words. Don't use words loosely, otherwise interaction is not possible. You may have the right understanding, but please stick to the words which are there. Otherwise, study Vedanta Paribhasha. If you do not have an idea, if even after this it is not clear, please study Vedanta Paribhasha. Okay, so with that, now let's look at the doshas. One is Satyavastu Anubhava Janya Samskaraha, which is needed. So Sarpa Brahma to take place, Sarpa's Samskara should be there, which should be Janya by the Satya Sarpa. That is one dosha. Pramatra dosha should be there. Pramatra doshas we'll talk about. Pramana doshas are there. So Pramata should have some doshas. This Jiva has some doshas due to which he sees Sarpa. Not all Jivas see Sarpa. Otherwise, if it is only based on Samskara, everyone has sarpa samskara, not everyone. Let's say you and I both have seen sarpa earlier, both have sarpa samskara, but I am not able to see the Rajju that you are seeing. I am able to see sarpa. You are not seeing sarpa. I am Bhramita, whereas you are not Bhramita. Why? Because Pramatra dosha, I have some dosha in me, some antakkarana, which is a visheshana to me, whereas me who I am Chaitanya, but you are also Chaitanya, but you are another jiva, I am another jiva, because your visheshana is different, my visheshana is different. You have a different antakkarana, therefore you are a different kind of a pramata, I am a different kind of a pramata, doshas are different. You don't have dosha there, I have dosha, therefore I am not able to see the Rajju that you are seeing clearly. I have Rajju Ajnana, but I have Sarpa Samskara, you also have Sarpa Samskara. Bheda is this dosha, whatever that Pramatra dosha is there, the Jiva dosha causes me to see Sarpa instead of Rajju. Then there has to be Pramana dosha also. Pramana dosha, we'll see more. Here Pramana is what? Indriya. So Indriya, taking Indriya in Chakshu, should have some issue. It is not able to see right. It cannot see the right kind of features of the rope. It misunderstands, feeds misunderstanding, does not itself misunderstand, it cannot misunderstand. It, the way it corrupts that vritti is such that I am not able to see rope, I see as sarpa. Therefore, pramana dosha has to be accepted. Prameya dosha has to be there. Prameya dosha is this Rajju itself has to have some characteristics of sarpa. Otherwise, it will not appear like sarpa. Otherwise, why does not Rajju appear as silver? Why Rajju appears only as sarpa, bhuchidra, mala? Why not Rajju appear as Ishwara, as Shiva or something? Does not happen. There has to be Prameya gata dosha also. Adhisthana vishesha ajnanam should be there, and Tatsamanya jnanam cha ityeta adhyasa samagriha. These five are adhyasa samagris. The last one being adhisthana vishesha ajnanam. In the case of Rajju Sarpa, Rajju is the adhisthana on which there is an adhyasa of Sarpa. So if you argue there that Atma is adhisthana Brahma, and this Bandha meaning the Dehadi are adhyasta on Atma, then Atma as adhisthana should not be known. So adhisthana vishesha ajnanam should be there. Meaning the Rajju Sarpa example, the Rajju vishesha should not be known. This ayam Rajjuhu, iyam Rajjuhu. So iyam Rajju, this is a Rajju. When I say this is a rope, that rope is vishesha and this is the Samanya. So this should be known. Something should be known. Something should be there. It should not be pitch dark. If it is pitch dark, you won't see anything. If it is fully bright, you won't see Sarpa. So Vishesha would become known. So in the setup should be such that the Rajju Adhisthana, in the example, Adhisthana Vishesha Ajnana should be there. So rope, the ropeness should not be known. But that samanya jnanam cha, samanya jnana should be there. You should be able to see this. There is something. This. What I see here, I see something. There is something. So that object should be seen as this, but not as this is a rope. So ropeness is not seen. Thisness is definitely seen. Iti eta adhyasa samagriya. Vinatu abhihi. Adhyasa evana siddhye. Without all of these five being there, adhyasa cannot be established. There won't be an adhyasa at all. Now he'll analyze the example. Shuktikayam rajata adhyasa rajvam va rajvam sarpadhyasascha jayate. So we know these examples, that in a shell we see some silver is seen. So we see silver. Silver is adhyasa. There is a rajata adhyasa. There is an adhyasa of silver on Shuktika. And on Rajju, there is an adhyasa of sarpa. So that is born, jayate. Adhyasa is definitely seen there. Sacha yasya paramartha satya rajata sarpa dyanubhavahita samskaraha vartate tasyeva jayate. One who sees silver in shell and one who sees sarpa instead of rope. So in means instead of shuktika, one sees silver without seeing the shell. That person should have seen silver elsewhere. Otherwise, he'll not be able to see silver. He may see something shining, but if he is seeing silver, he says, oh, I see silver, then he should know silver. Similarly, one who says, I see sarpa, he should know sarpa. He should have seen sarpa earlier. So, paramartha satya, that is paramartha satya there, from the Purvapakshi perspective, that satya that he sees is paramartha, that sarpa or rajata, silver or sarpa, he should have seen earlier. And anubhava of that rajata or sarpa that he had sometime earlier, anubhava ahita samskara, that samskara is created, impression in the mind is already there, that I know what is silver, what is sarpa. Vartate tasyeva jayate. So only one who has silver knowledge, jnana and anubhava, and one who has sarpa anubhava, that kind of person alone can see silver instead of shell and sarpa instead of rajju. So that is the first one. Tadrahitasya tuna. So one who does not have sarpa or rajata samskara, for him such a bhranti will not take place. Ityataha satya vastu pramahita samskaro adhyasa hetuhu. What is the hetu for adhyasa? Samskara, which is generated due to satya vastu prama. There should be a valid knowledge. It should not be a bhrama. Bhrama itself won't take place unless there is some samskara of a satya vastu. Satya means vyavaharika. Here we would say vyavaharika, at least vyavaharika. Satya vastu. Shuktikayam sarpadhyasasya rajyau rajatadhyasasya cha anudayat. Now he moves on to the second point, which happens to be dosha, which will lead to second type of dosha, which will lead to adhyasa. See, in shuktika, sarpadhyasa is not possible. In the shell, one does not see sarpa, one sees silver. And in rope, one does not see silver, one sees sarpa. So you cannot exchange. You cannot have any kind of adhyasa or brahma on any kind of substratum, adhisthana. There has to be a specific type of adhisthana. So prameya dosha, here he says that shuktikayam sarpadhyasasya rajyau rajatadhyasasya cha anudaya. Since such a thing is not seen as silver on rope or snake on shell, therefore prameya gata sadrishya dosha api adhyasa hetur bhavati. Therefore there is a sadrishya dosha. Sadrishya dosha is commented upon. This rajyau sarpavat kautilya jirghatvadi shuktaucha rajatavat chakachakyadi cha prameya gata sadrishya dosha. There has to be some similarity between what can be a possible as an adhyasa, the type of brahma, the vishaya that you see, brahma. That brahma, sarpa, should have some adhyasa to take place. Means sarpa to be seen, the sarpa should have similar characteristics as rajju. So sarpavat, rajju has sarpavat characteristics, like sarpa, like kautilya, kutila. It is a little crooked, you know, movement can be crooked. Sarpa movement is crooked. Rajju can also be placed in a crooked manner, like sarpa. Dhirga, rajju is long. Sarpa is also long. Ityadi, others also can be taken. So whatever characteristics are there in sarpa, they should have similarity with the characteristics of rajju. Similarly, in shuktika or shukti, rajatavat, like silver, it has chakachakyadi. Chakachakyadi, it has a shine. So it shines like silver. That is a similarity. Shell has a shine, and the nacre has a shine, as well as the silver has shine. Therefore, silver can be a mistaken perception in the case of shukti, whereas sarpa can be a mistaken identity of rajju. That these are the prameya gata sadrushya dosha. So similarity is the dosha in the prameya. I'll just finish this para and stop. Maybe not para, maybe we'll see something little more. Started late. Therefore, prameyagata sadrushya dosho api adhyasa hetur bhavati. Evam, similarly, third point, pramatru gata lobha bhayadi doshaha. So, pramata प्रमाता जीवा शुड हैव सम लोभा फॉर सिल्वर. सो इफ ही हैज लोभा देन ही विल सी सिल्वर. इफ ही हैज भया सम फियर ऑफ स्नेक ही विल सी स्नेक. सो दिस इज अ पूर्व पक्षी आर्ग्यूमेंट दैट प्रमाता ऑल्सो हैज दोषा. ही विल नॉट सी सिल्वर अनलेस हिज माइंड इज डेलिविंग ऑन सिल्वर. यू नो ही हैज लोभा, ही वैल्यूज सिल्वर. सो दैट सिल्वर कम्स टू फोर फ्रंट वेन एवर ही सी समथिंग. सी वाई सो, बिकॉज सी इफ यू लुक एट अ पर्सन, someone should be in memory to trigger that kind of a memory. If you say no, you know, there are people who say, you know, this person looks like Pooja Swamiji, they value Pooja Swamiji. So if you say this person looks like Pooja Swamiji, that Pooja Swamiji's memory is there. One values that. So the value should be there. Then you look at someone, oh, you know, you remind me of Pooja Swamiji. You remind me of, my long lost friend. So you value that friend. Here also the lobha is said here, as he used the word lobha, that this is rajata lobha. Therefore he sees rajata in shuktika and bhaya. So it can be replaced with any word wherever, whatever is applicable. So adipadeni you can bring out whatever is applicable, value, respect, all of these can be there. So bhaya is possible in case of sarpa. Sarpa bhaya is there, that becomes the another ingredient, samagri for, this is in pramatrugata dosha. I have fear, jiva has fear, jiva has bhaya, jiva has lobha. So therefore, he sees silver in shell and sees sarpa in rajju. Chakshuradi pramanagata kacha kamaladi doshascha adhyasa hetavaha. Similarly, this pramanagata dosha also have to be there. Kacha kamaladi, so some whatever defects you consider, cataract or squint eye, whatever, not having 20/20 vision. I mean, very rarely anyone has 20/20 vision these days. The food is, is not pure, weather is not pure, eating habits are not pure, timing is not pure, fast food culture, all of that has affected. You see, even in kids, at a very, very, nascent stage in life, they get spectacles. So chakshuradi pramanagata kacha kamaladi doshascha adhyasayetava. They'll also, you should not be able to see clearly. Even if you say that, eyes cannot see in that dim light. That is chakshu dosha. Chakshu has a dosha that it cannot see all the time. It cannot see in darkness. It cannot see in dim lit areas. That is chakshurantargata dosha. So pramanagata dosha has to be accepted. If I can see in dark, if my eyes could facilitate such a possibility, then I would not see rope as snake. Chuktikayam rajatadhyasa samaye iyam iti adhisthana samanya jnane sati iyam shukti iti vishesha jnane asati cha adhyasa bhavati. And the last point is the samanya jnana of thisness should be there and vishesha jnana of shell or rope should not be there. So iyam shukti should be there. Iyam should be there, but iyam shukti jnana should not be there. Iyam, this jnana should be there. Rajatadhyasa samaya, at that point of time, I should know there is something which I can see as an object as this. So thisness is known. Iti adhisthana samanya jnana is there. And that being there, that is not sufficient. I should not have shukti jnana. If I see immediately, I see shukti also, brahma will not take place. Iti vishesha jnane asati cha adhyasa bhavati. So fifth point is also needed. Fifth samagri. Shukti iti vishesha jnane sati va iyam iti samanya jnane asati va adhyaso naiva jayate. In case one has vishesha jnana of shukti at that point of time, mind you, shukti one may know shell, but at that point of time one does not know shell there. So vishesha jnana in that particular sthana vishesha. That sthana vishesha is there, kala vishesha is there, and that vastu vishesha is also there. Regarding that particular shell also, if there are 10 shells there, if you see 9 shells, but only on one there is sunlight falling, a beam of light, let's say, and only one shuktika is shining, you don't know that as shuktika. Maybe 9 you know as shuktika. You have that knowledge of 9 shuktikas in that desha, that kala itself, but vastu vishesha is there. That tenth shell you don't know as shell. You know there is something. You can't call it as a tenth. You call it as something is there, and then you end up calling it as silver. So something, thisness is known. That shukti iti vishesha jnane sativa. If you know that shukti also as shukti, and thisness iti, this iti samanya jnane asati. If you don't know it as this, you know shukti, but you don't know it as here. You don't know anything there. You don't see anything like shukti or anything there. Then that will not help. There Brahma will not take place. You will not see anything there. If you see something and you don't see the vishesha, then only Brahma can take place. Tasmad adhisthana samanya jnanam tad vishesha ajnanam cha adhyasa hetu. Not knowing the vishesha and knowing the samanya alone is adhyasa hetu. Further now, he concludes by saying, Purvokta samagrinam panchanam atyantam abhave na adhyasa siddhyati. Purvokta samagrinam panchanam anyatama bhave na adhyasa siddhyati. Even if one is lacking, all five are needed. If one is lacking, anyatama is one among many. So one among many, among five, if even one samagri is lacking, you cannot have adhyasa. You may cook up something, but that cannot be called as food. So if you say, oh, I cooked up something, it's not that particular food. So the person who has a taste for a particular food item, that person can know something is missing. You say salt is less, sugar is less. Something is less. Or even in multiple vegetables that go in a particular dish, everything is mixed up. The color looks same. But while tasting, this is lacking. I don't taste it at all. You have put it less. So all have to be there. Otherwise, then he'll say, I have never tasted this kind of, it is not tasty. So he'll say, I can't call it that particular dish. You can call it by any name. Don't call it that particular dish. It's an insult. Why? Because this particular ingredient has not gone in. Similarly here, adhyasa, don't call it as adhyasa. If one of them is missing, adhyasa is not possible. Ghatotpattau kulala danda chakra mrut saliradayaha samagraha. You need all of these. When you are making a pot, so potter, kulala is needed, potter is needed, danda is needed to move the chakra is needed so that it can be moved, mrut is needed, clay. Without clay, you cannot make, and salila, some water is to be mixed in. All of these are needed. All of these are needed as samagris to make ghata. So this is the karana kalapa in ghata, ghata utpatti. Yatha etesham anyatama bhave naiva utpadyate ghata ha. If you say potter is missing, let's make a pot. Pot is not possible. You have to play the role of the potter. So you have to substitute. Potter has to be there. You become the potter. Danda is not there. Danda is not there. What do I do? Something should play the role of danda. If the exact is not there, you use whatever is available, but that has to play the role of danda. Chakra has to be there. Mrut has to be there. Salila has to be there. If anything is missing, anyone, naiva utpadyate ghataha, tatha adhyasa samagrinam anyatama bhave api adhyaso no utpadyate, no utpadyate. Similarly, there is no possibility. No utpadyata means what? No utpadyata means there is not even shakyata is also not there of adhyasa if any one of the five that I have told you are missing, says the Purvapakshi. Tasmat purvoktanam panchanam samagrinam avashyakatva tasam sarvasam satve eva adhyasa jayetan anyatha. And therefore, as he has established, all these five which he has talked about, those samagris have to be definitely there. And only if all of those are definitely there, adhyasa is possible. And then he will show why it is not possible. None of these are possible in the case of this Brahma that you talk about in the context. So that we'll look at in the next part. I had to take a detour because I wanted to explain some fundamentals which have got mixed up in time. So we revisit them as needed. So we cover a little bit of both, foundation also becomes stronger and we understand the grantha also, and it is helpful overall. So it can lead us to the prayojana of the grantha in an easier manner. That's the reason to look at foundations again and again, fundamentals. Okay. सत्यम सुखम नित्यम स्वप्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्व्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वोन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस? I mean, this was for everyone because, you know, some people don't ask questions. They do have questions for whatever reasons. So I thought sometimes, you know, revisiting fundamentals may be useful. Okay. Namaste.
Namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.